when I opened up the book, I didn't understand anything, you know, and mind was not, you know, I was not in that frame of mind. So it took me a while to, you know, get the feel of it. And it was a bit difficult in the beginning to comprehend things and to retain the matter because, you know, so, but gradually it became easier and easier as we went along.
I deal with a lot of foreign trained students and, you know, students that go to the UK, India, Pakistan, all kinds of places, and then they come because they need to article. And so considering my father is one of those people, I try to support them as much as I can because I know how difficult it is in firsthand, how difficult it is that he had to do something at this age just to get it over with. You need to know what you're doing in this jurisdiction and you need to be pretty good at it because your decisions affect a lot of people's lives. If you're doing criminal law or if you're doing family law, people can lose their children if you don't know what you're doing. I mean, that can happen to people that are trained as well. It can happen, but I think that when you're coming from a different jurisdiction, if the subjects that you've taken or if the system, the legal system is different there, then you need to learn it here.
But this son of mine, he didn't let me retire. He doesn't want me to retire. He forced me to go and complete all these. Otherwise, I was not very eager to do it. Of course, I did miss my law practice. And had I not done all this, I probably would have gone back and started my practice. Because once a lawyer, you're always a lawyer.
So he was very supportive in the beginning of my career and throughout. That's why I saw the passion that he had still. And I felt that he was kind of living vicariously through me at that time. So I wanted him to be able to feel it again. Because to be honest, he does work like he's 26 or 28. He's very good at what he does. So, you know, he's very fresh. He retains everything that he's learned, which is surprising. And, you know, it makes me want to work harder as well. So, you know, I owe my success to my father. You know, he's been very supportive.
It's good to have retired life, but I feel personally, as long as you live, you should not stop contributing towards the society. Age is just a number. You should continue whatever you can do. Does not matter if a government gives you facility because you retire, no. You should give back. Whatever you can do, you should continue, you know, rather than just sit at home and read newspaper. You should contribute to the society, and does not matter what age you have.